In this video, I'm going to share with you the 5 software tools that I use to record my screen so that I can use it for YouTube videos, social media videos, training videos, summit videos, and also stick around till the end and I'll tell you my favorite tool that I use out of those 5. But before we do that, let's roll the intro.
My name is Rob Balasabas.
Hey! Welcome to my webcam. This is my webcam view now, and we're gonna dive right into the different tools. So here's the first one. I'm gonna share my screen now. Ready? 3, 2, 1. Let's go. All right, so here we go. So I'm right here at the bottom right of your screen, and then the little bubble. Hello, good to see you. Okay, so this is the first tool that I use. It's called Loom. This tool is amazing. I've used this tool hundreds of times for hundreds of videos, and I'm gonna do a little bit of a scroll as I talk, but I love this tool. It's used by a lot of different companies, big companies, small companies, entrepreneurs, intrapreneurs, solopreneurs, all sorts of businesses and brands. And so this is Loom. I use the Chrome extension version of this tool. So in this video, I want to make sure that I touch on the pricing for every single tool that I'm sharing. So when it comes to Loom, they have a great basic free plan. So this is for individuals that just need to record and share quick videos. The video that you record is stored on the cloud on the Loom website, and I'll show you that in a second. And then what you can do is you can share a link so that you can actually use this to send messages to colleagues or partners or people that you want to connect with. Then what you can do is you can download that video, and then you can download that video and use it in your YouTube videos. You can put into your video editing tool and use that version of that downloaded Loom video inside of YouTube or social media videos or inside of your course if you're creating online courses. Whatever it may be, you can get a downloaded version, an MP4, which is the video file of that video that you created and recorded using Loom. All right, and I want to quickly show you what it looks like in the dashboard and how it looks like when you're about to record a video using Loom. And for all of these tools, I will be creating its own separate video, tutorial videos for each of these tools so that you can get a more deeper dive into how to use these tools specifically. So if you have any questions about them, make sure to leave them in the comments. I'll make sure to answer them in future videos or directly in the comments down below. What you'll get with Loom is you'll install a Chrome extension. You'll see that here. And what I will do is I'm gonna click that. Oh, now you've got another video of me in the bottom left. And so this is actually really cool with Loom is that you get this little bubble as well, similar to eCamm, which is what I'm using now. And you can kind of move it around. So it's kind of cool that way. You can also make it a little bit bigger if you like. So I can make this a little bit bigger so that my head bubble, talking bubble is a little bit bigger. So it shows up on the screen a little bit more, or even really, really big. And you'll see that right here in this version right here, which is a little bit too big, I think, but I'm gonna make sure I minimize that. You can also get rid of it if you like. So you can actually close it out and remove it from the screen altogether. Now on the top right here, I'd like to bring your attention. You can record your full desktop or just the current tab that you're in. Okay, you can also record the audio if you like, or not the audio if you don't like. You can also record the screen and the webcam if you like, or just the screen, or just a cam if you like. That means your webcam, so it doesn't show your screen. There are also advanced options, so you can select a camera source if you have an external camera or a DSLR camera that you'd like to use. You can also use photos for screen only. You can take away the control menu. You can take away the recording countdown, all those little things, all those little details. And then once you're ready, you click on start recording. And essentially, it's gonna go live. It's gonna record the screen or your webcam at the same time, and away you go. Okay, so here is an example of a video that I recorded on Loom. You'll see here there's a little download button right here. There's also a duplicate video button. You can also delete the video if you like, or you can copy the link. See this big blue button that says copy link? You can copy that link and send it to anyone that you like. You can send it on by email, by messenger, by DM, by text, whatever you like, and somebody can watch this exact video that you just recorded without you having to download that video for them to then download it on their side. All you need to do is copy this link, send it to them, and they'll be able to watch it on the Loom website directly without an account. If you'd like, you can also make sure it's secure. You can add a password to this video for someone that you are sharing it with. And again, it just really helps make sure that that is private. And also, again, this is something I'll deep dive into when I create a tutorial on Loom, is that you can trim the video. So if you wanted to take out the beginning, a little bit of the beginning, or maybe a bit of the end, or anything like that, you can actually do some basic video editing here as well. So there you have it. So that is Loom. Now let's jump into the next tool. The next tool that I want to show you guys is Vidyard. So the next tool is Vidyard. It's a really awesome tool. They're a Vancouver-based company, so go Canada. It is a awesome tool as well. So I'm going to scroll down just like I did with Loom, used by lots of big companies as well, HubSpot, LinkedIn, Microsoft, really big company, Salesforce. So it's awesome. So again, this is primarily for recording your screen as well as then having your webcam turned on so that your face is also visible in a little bubble somewhere on the screen. So I want to make sure that we go over pricing. So Vidyard does have a free forever plan, which is free 99, free $0 per month, no credit card required. You can upload and share unlimited videos and embed up to 5 on your website or blog or somewhere on the internet. So that's the limit there. So if you're not using the videos to be embedded into your website or your blog or anything, then you can run Vidyard for free forever, $0 per month. It then goes up from there to $15 a month to $150, $850 a month, all the way up to their custom enterprise pricing plans. So there you go. So that's how the pricing works with Vidyard. Now let me show you what it looks like on the back end on how it actually looks when you are creating videos using Vidyard. So similar to Loom, if you go to this little Chrome extension that I've installed, it takes 2 seconds to install. I can click on the Vidyard Chrome extension and this pop-up comes up, looks kind of similar to Loom. You have 3 options. Camera only. So if you just want to record yourself on a webcam, perfect. This is the option for you. You can also choose the screen option. So this will record your entire screen. When you have multiple screens, there will be a pop-up that asks you which screen you'd like to record. Or you can click on the tab option, which just records a specific tab on your Chrome browser. There's 2 other options here. One is to turn off the microphone and another one to turn off the camera, which you'll see here. I'll turn it off. Now my little Vidyard window bubble, webcam bubble is gone. And then I'm back. And then also similarly to Loom, you can choose which camera that you'd like to use. At this time, I only have 1 camera, which is my webcam. But if I was to connect my external camera, my DSLR camera, it would show up as an option here as well. Or I can turn off the camera altogether. Now, once you've recorded the Vidyard videos, it shows up here in the library in the back end of your Vidyard account. I have quite a few that I've created. Here's a video that I created recently for a little quick message to a friend of mine inside of the Social Media Examiner crew over there in San Diego. So again, you can just watch this. You can share this as well with them directly. So you can share the link. So you don't have to download the video to share it with somebody else, but you can download the video if you'd like to use it for your YouTube channel, for social media, or for, you know, online courses or a virtual summit that you are participating in. All right, so there you have it. That is Vidyard. I think that's how you say it. Now, if you have any questions about Vidyard, let me know in the comments. Also, you can find links to check out all of these awesome tools in the description. So make sure you hit that subscribe button while you're down there and come up and let's go into the next tool. The next tool is Camtasia by TechSmith. I love this tool. I'm gonna scroll while I talk about it. Now, you can use Camtasia to record your screen, but it is also more than that. It is a complete video editor, and I'll show you guys that in a second. Now, Camtasia does cost, there is a free trial, but it does cost a little bit of money. I do recommend you to purchase the full license just because it is so powerful. So here is the pricing page for all the TechSmith products. Now you'll see Camtasia is about $346 Canadian. You can also purchase the bundle, which includes Camtasia and Snagit, which is at a discounted $380 Canadian, so that you get both of these amazing tools. Now Snagit, I don't mention it too much here, but it's an awesome tool as well for screen capture. So if you want to take a picture of your screen, for example, and then sort of annotate on it, meaning like draw on it or you know, give some feedback on something, it's an awesome tool for that as well. And I will be creating tutorials for both of these awesome tools. Now, let me show you really quickly Camtasia in action and how that looks like, because I am using it to edit this exact video. All right, so here we are. This is my Camtasia account. So you'll see my timeline here at the bottom. You'll see the media files here on the top left, and then also sort of the main window here that shows what I am working on the top right. All right, so let me just minimize my screen a little bit so you can kind of see the top left of this Camtasia window with the record button. So if I click on record, so you'll see my kids here. This is a picture of us in London, in Shoreditch, during a recent family vacation, but that's just my background. Sorry, guys. So you'll see this little Camtasia pop-up that comes up, and basically there's four options. There's four elements that you can record on your screen. You can record your monitor, so the actual screen itself. You can also record the webcam, so me talking, you'll see that right there pop up. You can also record the audio, so you'll see that right there. And I can choose which audio source I want, whether it's the built-in microphone or my external microphone. And lastly, you can record the system audio, so the little clicks and all those things, you know, the sound that comes in from your computer itself. Now, you can record just one of these or combinations of two or three, whatever it is that you're recording, which is why I love Camtasia so much, because sometimes I'm just using it to record audio. Sometimes I'm just using it to record the screen. So then I will just record my screen. And sometimes I'm recording all of it, right? So that's why I love Camtasia so much. Such an awesome, versatile tool in that sense. All right, so that's Camtasia. Let's get on to the next tool. All right, so this next tool is eCamm. eCamm is an amazing tool. You can check them out, eCamm.com. I've actually been using eCamm for quite a number of years now, probably 2 or 3 years. An amazing tool. I know the people there really, really well, Adrian and Katie, and just awesome, awesome people there. So eCamm is actually built for live streaming, but a lot of people don't realize this, but you can use eCamm to also record your screen along with your webcam. So you can show up on the webcam in the corner and then record your screen video as well. So eCamm Live is a tool that you can use to go live on Facebook or YouTube, anything like that as well. So it's awesome, I love it. But if you scroll down, here are the different platforms that you can go live on. So Restream.io, which gives you access to tons of platforms to go live on, Periscope, which is really Twitter Live, Twitch, Switchboard, other things like that. So this is what eCamm is commonly used for, like I said, for live streaming. So again, really, really important that eCamm is also only available for Mac users. So if you're on Windows, unfortunately, eCamm won't work for you, but I have a Mac and it works great. So if you are a Mac user, then eCamm is good to go. Now, let me show you how this works, how it looks to actually record your screen. All right, so here is my eCamm window. At the bottom right, what you'll see here says destination record only. And so that's the option that you would choose if you want to just record your webcam, using your webcam, so talking head like this, or on the top right, you can choose to share your screen like this. So now you see my screen, and then you also see me at the bottom of the screen. See that? So that's what that looks like there. So see, I can kind of move it around. There it is. So that's the screen right there. So that's the entire screen, which is my desktop. And then at the bottom, there is me as a talking head like that. Now, the cool thing with eCamm too is you can actually change the shape of that window with your head in it. So I can actually make it a square if I like, or I can make it a tall version of that, kind of like Instagram stories like this, which is kind of cool. And then I can kind of make that bigger if I like this, and then kind of move it around wherever I want on the screen like that. And then there's a couple other options, a couple other shapes of how that can look. Also wide is a good one like that. Again, really versatile tool, kind of cool how you can change all that up. And that is eCamm. Now let's go into pricing really quick before we go on to the next tool. A couple years ago when I started using eCamm, it was a one-time fee product. So you paid one time and then you had access to the product. And then if there was any updates and things like that, then you know, you may have to pay a little bit just to get the update or whatever it is. But what I like what they've done now is that they've actually transitioned to a monthly subscription. And so you get all the updates. There's tons of amazing things that you get each and every month. Whenever there's an update, you get access to it. So it starts for free. You get a 14-day trial to check it out. No credit card required. And then you can go into the standard plan, which is $12 a month, or billed as one payment of $144 for the year. And then also there's a pro version, which is $20 a month. So very affordable tool for what you're getting. You get a ton of awesome features in there. If you're live streaming, for example, this is a tool that you definitely need to check out and start using. But if you're just looking to record your videos, to record your screen and record your screen with your webcam as well, then it's an awesome tool for doing that. And now for the fifth tool, let me show you. I'm gonna search it right here on my screen. Are you ready? QuickTime. So at the bottom of my screen here, you'll see the QuickTime option. If I right click, I click on new screen recording. Now there's a little dotted line kind of box that I then choose to expand however big I like to select the section that is going to be recorded. And then essentially, I click on record and it's done. And so I love QuickTime. It's really easy for something really quick and easy like that. And that is QuickTime. Super, super simple. Awesome. So I hope that helps you with understanding some different tools that you can use to record your screen so that you can use it for all sorts of videos that you are creating. Personally, my favorite tool when it comes to recording my screen is Camtasia. I especially like Camtasia because after I record my screen, it drops it into the timeline right away. Because I use Camtasia for editing my videos. For example, this video right here is being edited on Camtasia. So that's my favorite tool, that's my go-to. If you have any questions around screen recording tools, anything else that I can help you with, leave me a comment. Let me know that you were here. Now, go and enjoy this next video. This video is a tutorial on how to sync up your audio and your video using iMovie, speaking of Mac. So go check that video out. Let me know if you have any questions. Make sure you subscribe, hit that notification bell, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.